Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Northeast High and Charlie Martin Memorial Stadium for the 1995 Catholic League Football Championship game, featuring the blue and gold LaSalle Explorers and in the white with the red and black trim, the Archbishop Ryan Raiders. There you see the toss of the coin at midfield. Referee Nick Ramo doing the honors. And Ryan has won the toss, will receive. At the west end of the stadium, LaSalle will kick off from the east. The records, LaSalle enters the game 10-2 with a 10-game winning streak. Ryan 8-4. These teams met earlier in the season at the end of September. Ryan had the game in control with a 19-7 lead. LaSalle roared back and won it 29-19. We'll be back in just a moment for the start of the ball game. All right, we're set to go. Mike Mack, number 16, ready to kick it off for the Explorers. Beautiful night here at Northeast. Just a gentle wind, not very cold at all. Tremendous crowd. Still filing in. Back deep for Ryan. Number 41, Drew Rakowski. Number 22, Chris Cavallaro. Here we go. Deep towards the corner. Rakowski takes it over his shoulder like a center fielder at about the 4. And he's hemmed in. Brought down at the 15-yard line. That's where Ryan will take over, 1st and 10. In the backfield for Ryan, the quarterback 16, Jason LePay, the fullback 25, Chris Kennedy, and there the tailback with the pitch out is Chris Cavallaro. He lined up wide to the right side, took the pitch out. Number 18, Jim Noon, up hard on the corner to make the tackle. Second down, 4 yards to go. Not the I formation again, Cavallaro split to the side. The give to Kennedy inside. Picks up about another 4 or 5 for the Raiders. John Clark among the tacklers. Third down, 2 to go in the eye. Cavallaro gets the first down. Jumps over the line of scrimmage. And the ball at the 27-yard line. Ryan, mostly a running team. On the season, Cavallaro, 1,032 yards. Kennedy, 785. LePay gets crunched. Breaking through the line of scrimmage, 77. Paul DeRazio. Second and 13, in motion is Joe Malley. The pitch to Cavallaro with Kennedy out front with a good block on one defender, but 5 or 6 more in the neighborhood. Kennedy couldn't take on all of them. Jason LePay on the season, 36 for 80, 428 yards, 1 touchdown. Here's his first pass of the night, complete, but it's going to be short of the first down to Tim Dumas. Caught it as he was falling. That'll bring up 4th down from the 30-yard line. In the time for the Raiders, Tom McKenna, the punter for Ryan. High snap, handles it. And a medium kick. Will not be a return. So LaSalle will take over, 1st and 10, from roughly the 43-yard line. LaSalle out on the ball with no huddle and a trips formation to the left. Brett Gordon, the quarterback, over 2,000 yards for the season. And he's ready to crank it up already. Incomplete, dropped by his leading receiver, Mike Mattia. 2nd down. Again, no huddle. This time, 2 backs in tight. And the give to Keith Lakowicz. He loses the ball. It's on the ground. Ryan recovers by number 41, Rakowski. The game's first turnover goes in Ryan's favor. 40 yards from the end zone. LePay, the give on a counter tray to Kennedy. Picks up about three. 34, Ed Boron on the tackle. Second and seven. Cavallaro, the inside handoff. Picks up about two. Third down, five to go from the 35 in motion is number one, Tim Dumas. LePay rolling to his opposite side, stepped in front, did. Noon could not make the interception. It'll be fourth down though. Now 35 yard line, we'll see what Ryan chooses to do. McKenna on, so we'll look for a punt. This is that gray area where you might think about going for it, might think of a fake. Instead, the punt from McKenna. Tight to the sideline, Mattia takes it on the 11, gets a nice little return. Mike Mattia returns it to about the 19-yard line. It'll be first and 10 Explorers. Ryan picked up 16 yards of field position. Gordon, all kinds of time. Downfield, catch made by Keith Lekowitz. So the first completion of the night for Brett Gordon, who in his season has 23 touchdown passes, one short of the city record, and he's only a sophomore. First down now at the 39-yard line. The two-back formation out of the shotgun. And that was movement. All the linemen just about moving before the ball was snapped. That'll push it back to the 34-yard line and make it first and 15. Brian Kersey closest to us, and Mike Mattia the wideouts. 14 is Kersey, 21 Mattia. Gordon downfield, catch made by Mattia. Not enough for the first down, but within 2 yards probably. Mike Mattia on the curl, puts LaSalle in good shape. Second and two, 47-yard line. Mattia in motion. Gordon steps up nicely, gets away from pressure. And Chris Kennedy horse collars him. So Kennedy with the tackle for a loss. It'll be third down and five. Third and four, let's make it from the 45. Gordon, pressure, and down he goes. Number nine, Brian McShane, who was a quarterback for part of the season, now playing defense, gets his opposite number. Brett Gordon on the sack. Drew Middlemiss. And angles it towards the right sideline. Gets a nice bounce and roll. Out of bounds at the Ryan 23. It'll be first and 10 there for the Raiders with 2:27 left. First quarter, we are still scoreless. Out of the eye to Cavallaro. Nothing doing. Coming up hard on the corner, Keith Lekowitz, the defensive end, tackles Cavallaro. Back to the 21-yard line, 2 yard loss. Cavallaro Cavalero looked tentative on that run, almost as if he were looking to get tackled as he was given the handoff. Now we have Lepe. Throws it up for grabs. Is it caught? A flag's down. Was the ball caught by Bruce Peltzer, 81? No, the signal is no catch, but let's see what the flag is. Probably interference of some description. Maybe a hold. Nick Ramo, the referee, getting the word. And there you see it, interference on the defense. So that'll be 15 yards from the original line of scrimmage, which was the 21. So we should be going to the 36. And first down for Ryan. Now the full house backfield. Kevin Campbell, number 49, comes in for blocking purposes. The play goes the opposite way, though, to give to Kennedy, and he picks up maybe two. The full house. Cavalero, running room, beyond the line of scrimmage, and then some. Nice tackle, number 72, Mike Sicardi, saving perhaps a touchdown. Cavalero has speed, just about broke that one across midfield to the 47. Pickup of 15, the counter tray, nowhere to go, Kennedy. Met by 41, Lakowitz, 68, Price. Loss of one. You see it, we're through one at Northeast Championship game, Catholic League 0-0, LaSalle and Ryan. We'll be back in a minute for the start of the second period. Second quarter, second down, 11 to go for Ryan and movement by number 54, the guard Joe Crow, and that'll cost Ryan five.
Second down, 17.
Second down, 16 to go after the penalty. LePay now looking to throw, won't have the time. In on him, 41, Lakowitz. 77, DeRazio. A sack back to the 43-yard line. So four more backwards.
43-yard line. Third and 20.
Keith Lakowitz, the defensive end and fullback, fumbled early in the game. He's seemed possessed ever since. The screen to Kennedy. He is going to get good yardage. The old dive into the pile. Noon, 18 on the tackle, and 41, Lakowitz. Tom McKenna on the punt for Ryan. Nice punt. It turns over on the spiral, and the fair catch made by Mattia. At about the 17-yard line. 10:26 before the half. We're still scoreless. Not a whole lot of action. It's LaSalle's turn. Gordon gives to Kyle Malik. His first carry of the night. Picks up about four or five. Mike Durso in the backfield. Number 23 has been out for the last few weeks with two screws at the base of his thumb, playing with a cast. And here he gets the ball. He's right-handed. The cast is on the left hand, so it's not a big problem. Picks up yardage to about the 26-yard line. Third and one. It screams run, but Gordon with the arm. Let's see how LaSalle opts to play it here. And it is Durso on the run. and more than enough yardage for the first down. Number one, Dumas on the tackle, along with 22, Caballero. First down, 35-yard line. Thurso picked up 9. Again, Thurso picks up about 4 or 5. Ed Pizarik on the tackle. In the regular season game against Ryan, Gordon threw for 173 yards and 3 touchdowns. In motion that time was Jack Hammond. Gordon thought long, then instead goes underneath to Kyle Malik. That'll be a first down. Malik gets 8 on the reception. This time it's Mattia in motion. And a lot of possibilities. He chooses underneath to Mattia, and he's knocked out of bounds by Tim Dumas. So LaSalle starting to put it up a little bit now. That's 2 passes in a row. Complete. There you see Brett Gordon, the quarterback, about to get the play from the offensive coordinator, Drew Gordon, who happens to be his father. Fourteen on that play. Kyle Malik, a lot of room, barely being touched. Down inside the 10-yard line. Kyle Malik broke that one easily. Long gain, down to the 9. Give him 30 yards. LaSalle on the doorstep. First and goal at the 9. Three first downs and 3 plays. Trips right. Malik goes in motion the other way. Gordon back there by his lonesome. Still lots of time. Now he's being pressured. Pops it up into the end zone. Intended for 14, Kersey. More than likely was throwing that away. Incomplete. Second and goal from the 9. A flag is up and Gordon is down. 85, Ed Pizarik on the tackle. Now sometimes with the intricate offense that LaSalle runs, we have illegal receivers going downfield. Let's see what the call is. And Nick Ramo seeking a clarification. Procedure. Ryan will refuse that one, of course, with the sack back to the 19-yard line. Loss of 10, so now it's third and goal from the 19. Usual situation there. Most of the time, in fact, almost always, you'll see procedure, motion, those kind of things called before the snap, and the play will not take place, but it did, and LaSalle lost 10. The fake to Malik, Gordon stopped short. Intercepted at about the 5. Number 59, Dave Ault with the interception. And LaSalle loses the great chance to take the lead. There you see the happy Dave Ault running off the field after the interception. And Ryan will take over now. First and 10 at the 7-yard line. Jason LePay to Caballero. Drew Middlemiss, 46, leads the tacklers. Pickup of 3 yards to the 10. Second and 7 from the 10. Caballero again, tripped up behind the line of scrimmage. Brendan Coyle, 47. With the trip. Ryan coach Glenn Gallione, not a big fan of the forward pass, but Ryan deep in its own end, needs seven. The give to Cavallaro, big hit put on him by number 51. That is Pat Coyle, Brendan's brother, really slammed Cavallaro. So a great defensive job by LaSalle on those three plays, and they will force the punt. Two yards deep in his end zone is Tom McKenna, ready to punt it away, he hopes. No problems, and a fair catch. Called for and made by Ed Boron at the 40. Again, LaSalle, decent field position, 40 yards away from taking the lead, 3:39 to go in the half. Trips right. Gordon, inside give. Whoa. Met by the rock. Chris Kennedy was Durso. Only loses one. Gordon has four completions on the evening. Looking for number five. Over the middle. Caught, juggled, caught again. Jack Hammond just short of the first down. LaSalle in four down territory, only needs one. Might they try for a home run here? No, they play it safe. Kyle Malik gets the first down. Tackle number nine, McShane Ed Pizarik also helped out. First down Explorers from the 29 yard line. 2:19 to go in the half. Gordon over the middle to Hammond. A little bit behind him, can't hold on. And that'll bring us to the 2 minute warning, officially 1:58 remaining in the first half. And when we come back, it'll be second and 10 for LaSalle from the 29. Second and 10, 29. In motion, Mattia. Gordon, a lot of choices, can't make one in time. See ya. 59, Dave Ault, who earlier had the interception, makes the sack back to the 38 yard line. Ryan defensive coordinator Lee Marvel trying to give a lot of different defensive looks to LaSalle, and Explorers call time. 1:23 left, second quarter, we're still scoreless. Ball on the 38 yard line. Third down, 19 yards to go. So LaSalle needs a big one. Gordon going for it. To Mattia, the dive. Can't quite get it. Just out of his reach. Lou Decree, 27, defending on the play. In punt formation, Drew Middlemiss. Drew Rakowski back. And that's going towards the corner. Will it wind up short of the goal line? Yes, it will, at the one. Keith Lakowitz hustles downfield. The snapper hustles downfield to down it at the, maybe the two it'll be. But anyway, Ryan against its own end zone at the two. Under a minute now. LaPe just sneaks it. Trying to get some breathing room up to about the 5 yard line. 40 seconds, timeout called by LaSalle. There you see Joe Calistra, the head coach of the Explorers, with the top coat on. And speaking to his offense with the red sweatshirt is Glenn Gallione of Ryan. Thirty-nine seconds remaining. Second and seven from the five. To play it safe again. Kennedy, the fullback, picks up another three or four. Again, LaSalle using the timeout in case they are able to force a turnover. Third 33 seconds now. Cavallaro gets it outside. Bobbing and weaving. Tackle made by Noon. The Raiders use the timeout and they come out with a passing formation. Two wideouts to the left. Let's see what it means. It means a give inside to Chris Kennedy. And he goes nowhere. 47, Brendan Coyle leads the tacklers. And now we're just going to probably run out the first half. That'll be the last play. Ball placed at the 18-yard line. 2-1, that'll do it. We're through the half at Northeast High. As you see, all kinds of zeros. Ryan and LaSalle, scoreless. We'll be back for the second half later on. Stick with us. While we watched the Archbishop Ryan band perform here at halftime, we thought we might give you some first half statistics. For LaSalle, for Archbishop Ryan, 56 yards total offense. Chris Cavallaro has 10 carries, 36 yards. Chris Kennedy, 6 for 13. And Jason LePay, 3 carries for minus 4. That's a total of 39 yards rushing. Passing, LePay, just 3 attempts, 2 completions for 17 yards. Kennedy caught 1 for 13. And Tim Dumas, 1 for 4. For the LaSalle Explorers, 85 yards total offense. How that breaks down? The leading rusher, Kyle Malik, on the strength of the 30-yard burst, 3 carries, 36 yards. Mike Durso, 4 carries for 17. Keith Lakowitz, only 1 carry so far. He fumbled on that play, lost 3 yards. And Brett Gordon, 4 carries. He's been dumped all 4 for losses, minus 27. Passing, Brett Gordon, 5 for 10, 1 interception, 65 yards. He spread the ball around. To Keith Lakowitz has 1 catch. Kyle Malik has 1. Jack Hammond has 1. And with 2 receptions, the leader, Mike Mattia, 2 for 27 yards. We'll be back later on for the second half, so stick with us. Let's do it. Second half coming up. Nick Ramo, the referee, talking again with the captains. This time, LaSalle will be receiving at the west end. Ryan kicking off from the east. The handshakes, head slaps, pleasantries. That'll be the end of that for the evening. We're scoreless at halftime. LaSalle and Ryan. There you see Tom McKenna, 87, preparing to kick it off. Kersey and Mattia, the two usually sure-handed receivers, back as return men. It won't get to them. Yes, it will. Ed Boron caught it and pitched it back. And the return up to about the 31. One-yard line. Gordon to Durso. Fends off the first would-be tackler. Kevin Campbell brought down by Ed Pizarik. Again to the 35. Let's call it 4. From the shotgun. Durso, the give, gets a good block out in front from Malik, 42. So Durso brought down by Lou Decree. Not before he gets first down yardage. up to the Explorer 45-yard line. Derso playing with the broken hand. Broken thumb, actually, the base of his thumb. Gordon, wide open is Kersey, looks it in, fumbles, picks it back up, and picks up the first down. All kinds of action on that play. Brian Kersey from Brett Gordon. First down again. Derso on the inside handoff out of the shotgun. 25, Kennedy, 27, Decree. Gordon, down. Ed Pizarik this time. He had a sack earlier in the game. Gets another one. Loss of one on the play. This offense ever dangerous. No home runs yet. Gordon throws underneath to Malik. Sidesteps almost Kevin Campbell. Trips him up. Down to the 37-yard line. Not enough for first down yardage. So the punt. Ryan comes hard. Cavallaro got close, and the ball into the end zone. So Drew Middlemiss, the 37-yard punt. Ryan will take over. First and 10 from the 20 on the touchback. First possession of the second half for the Raiders. Starts with the pitch out to Cavallaro. Bruce Peltzer, 81, and Kennedy out as blockers, but only a short gain. Second and six in the eye. LePay now rolling. Sets. Almost picked off by 51. Coyle. Incomplete to Dumas. And we have an Explorer down. Not sure who that is. John Matlick, 22, brother of Kyle, was the injured Explorer. He came off under his own power. Happy to see that. Jason LePay under pressure from Price, gets rid of it, and it's incomplete. So Price was hanging all over LePay, and LePay lucky to get rid of the ball. He was looking at about a 10-yard loss there. Brings us to fourth down, though. With this many people at a game, you get a certain percentage that don't come to high school games very often. A lot of the fans were yelling, in the grasp, in the grasp. That's not a high school rule. McKenna, the punt. Caught by Boron at the Ryan 48. And with not a whole lot of room, carves out about a 5-yard return. Ed Boron. .6:25 left, third quarter. Gordon steps up. Campbell was in his face almost, and under pressure throws it way long. Now Gordon yelling at Brian Kersey to get on the opposite side of the field. Trips left. Hammond, it is in motion. Gordon gets past Pizarik, room to go towards the left sideline. First down, Explorers. Drew Gordon flushed out of the pocket, makes something out of it. 15, Bill Fulforth on the tackle. Ball on the 28 now. Gordon does a lot of audibles at the line of scrimmage. That's an inside give to Durso. Could have been even much better. Ran into one of his own blockers. Brought down by Decree. They'll take it down to the 24. Sean Hunsaker, the center for LaSalle, over the ball. The pitch to Malik. Cavallero on the stop. Close to first down yardage. We'll have a measurement here to see whether Kyle Malik picked up sufficient yardage for the first down. And just a little bit short. You hear the groans from the Explorer fans down below. Third and inches. What do you do? Take the first down or go for the homer? Brian Kersey has single coverage at the top of the screen. Bill Fulforth, everyone else bunched at the line of scrimmage. Now Fulforth backs off and Gordon's going to sneak it, picks up the first down. Down to the 17-yard line. I was kind of surprised by that. Drew Gordon, sort of a riverboat gambler, but they took the first down. Now Kyle Malik on the try for the outside yardage. Gets dumped at about the line of scrimmage. Three and a half minutes remaining, third quarter. Second down, 10, Mattia in motion. Gordon steps up, picks up a couple, brought down by Kennedy. Third and 9. To the right side along the sideline, Mattia catches the ball inside the 5, makes a beautiful spin move on Dumas to stay in bounds and pick up another 4 down to the 1. It doesn't get much better than this. First and goal at the 1. How can you not score? Gordon to Malik. Is he in? Yes. Kyle Malik over the right side. The Raiders, as you see, disputing the touchdown call. But he appeared to be in from here. It's a tough angle, of course. Rakowski, 41, was holding on, trying to pull him back. Couldn't do it. LaSalle, 6. Ryan, no score. 2:22 left, third quarter. Gordon to kick it out of the hold of Hammond. It's up and perfect. 7-0. The LaSalle Explorers over the Archbishop Ryan Raiders. Third quarter action. In case you didn't believe it, there it is. Mike Mack to kick it off. Line drive. Picked up on the bounce by Rakowski at the 17, hustling downfield, number 7, Tim McNichol. Yard line, no reason to panic, 7-0. LePay looking to throw and just dumps it under pressure. No one even remotely close to the ball. The LaSalle assistant screaming for an intentional grounding call, but he was just dumping the ball, getting rid of it. No harm. LePay, the lefty. Give to Cavallero. Ed Boron stuck him like crazy. Pick up to the 31, 3 yards. Third down, 7 to go. Tim Dumas, the bottom of your screen to the left. LePe falls down. He would have been sacked anyway. Drew Middlemiss was just about to plant him. LePe slipped on a little bit of the muddy part of the field there. And it brings us to fourth down. LaSalle should come out of this with great field position again. McKenna bobbles. LaSalle not in there in time to make it a real dangerous situation. Now Mattia made a fair catch and took a couple of choppy steps. They could have opted for a penalty there. Instead, it'll be first and 10 at the Ryan 48. Seconds left in the quarter. Gordon, a draw to Lakowicz, all kinds of room. Still on his feet, and finally pushed out of bounds. It's Keith Lakowicz. Blue Decree, 27-9, Chris McShane on the tackle. That's the first true draw play, I believe, of the night for the Explorers. Picks up tremendous yardage. Yard line, 21 yards on the play. Now Malik makes something out of nothing. Could have been dropped for a loss. Instead, picks up about 2. That'll do it. We're through 3 at Northeast High. LaSalle, 7. Ryan, no score. LaSalle, 25 yards away from another score. Second and 8 from the 25. Gordon, the bootleg. Underneath, Kyle Malik had the reach for that one as he was turning. Chris McShane hit him right in the belly. Our apologies to Ryan's number 9. It's Brian McShane. I believe I've called him Chris a couple times. Underneath to Hammond. And he's down inside the 15-yard line. So Jack Hammond, not one of the primary receivers, mostly a blocker, chips in with a nice catch. First down. On the 15, first and 10. Brett Gordon needs one touchdown pass to tie the city record. Now it'll be a run. It's Kyle Malik down inside the 10. Good yardage again. Kyle Malik picked up 6. At the 9, second down. Durso, not much room. Number 40, Jason Zernicki on the tackle. Down to the 8-yard line. On the right side of that line for LaSalle, Bill Donahue, 71. Dave Wickersham, 64. Gordon, Decree arrives at the last second, knocks the ball away from Jack Hammond. That brings us to fourth down. And it's going to be a field goal attempt. 26 yards by Brett Gordon. You've heard his name often. Seen his arm. Now the kick. And now not the kick, as we had some whistles just before the snap. It'll be a dead ball foul. And let's see, the LaSalle players seem to be happy. Maybe Ryan in its haste to block the field goal. There you see it, offsides on the defense. Now the line of scrimmage was the 8, so that should take us to the 4. And will that be enough for the first down? It should be. It should take us inside the 5-yard line.
Find a seat.
I know that the discrepancy here is LaSalle is asking whether the field goal counts, but I believe the whistle was blown from the referee's standpoint before the play officially began, so it's a dead ball foul. There you see Nick Ramo with the dead ball foul sign, so that means LaSalle can't take the 3 points, even if the Explorers would like to. But I'm sure they're not too unhappy with this. It's first and goal at the 4 on the offsides. A chance to go in for 6 or 7 instead of settling for 3. Double wideouts, Kersey and Mattia. The give to Durso. Is he in? No sign yet. He's in the end zone now. Did he hit the ground at all? I guess not. Touchdown. There's the signal. Mike Durso off right tackle. 4 yards for the touchdown. 9:51 left. LaSalle leads it now 13-0 over Ryan. Gordon, the kick, he pulled it left. Still good? Yes. That was close. Brett Gordon, one more point. 14-0 Explorers looking for their first championship since 1989. Mike Mack to kick it off. It's deep. Over his shoulder, Rakowski can't get it. It'll be a touchback. Ryan will take over at its own 20-yard line. Down 14 with 9:48 remaining. Have to start putting it up. Jason LePay, the quarterback. He's been back as the starter for the last 3 games. And they start with a draw play to Cavallaro. Drew Middlemiss on the tackle. Second and 10. If Ryan's going to come back here, Tim Dumas, among others, will have to get it done. LePay throws out of bounds along the far sideline, looking for Bill Fulforth, 15. Third down. Third down from the eye. The give on the outside, Cavallaro. First down, Chris Cavallaro. Ed Boron on the tackle. Under 9 minutes now. Cavallaro, 17 on the pickup. Two, Cavallaro. Nothing doing, Keith Lakowicz. Second and 13. Wanted to go long. He wanted to go long. Keith Lakowicz would have none of it. Another tackle for a loss. A sack. LePay. Two, not a Ryan Raider, intercepted. Number 45, Todd Carmody. The pass intended for Matt Weed, Carmody stepped in front. LaSalle now in tremendous shape. Up 14 with the ball and inside Ryan territory at the 48-yard line. The give to Lakowicz. Maybe lost a yard. Six and a half minutes left. Some of the Ryan fans starting to file out. Not a good feeling about their ball club's chances. And that might be a delay of game. It seemed like the Explorers were in the huddle for a long time. And it is. The signal came from the back. Nick Rambo will repeat it. And it will cost the Explorers five. Gordon will keep it. Gets a block from 53. Jerry Kilkenny, and picks up a couple. Now this is an illegal formation. Let's see if the referees caught it. Five in the backfield, definitely. Pass by Gordon to Mattia, broken up. And indeed, we have a flag down from the far side.
Pass was complete, but there is a flag on the play.
We had quadruple right there for a second until Malik went in motion. Gordon by himself with lots of time. Kersey, we might have some linemen downfield though. Brian Kersey makes the catch along the right sideline. But I think we have, there it is, linemen downfield on LaSalle. Third and a bundle. The draw to Lakowicz and picks up two or three. Ryan will be coming hard. The Raiders have had a lot of success in the last few years with blocking kicks, punts, changed a lot of games around, and here they come. Not nearly fast enough. Middlemiss gets it off. And Rakowski skidded as he came up trying to make the return. And Ryan again with not desirable field position. First and 10, 24-yard line. LePe. Cavallero on the pitch out. Carmody on the tackle. Short game for Cavallero. You have to wonder how much Ryan was affected by losing on Thanksgiving to George Washington of the Public League for only the second time in the history of that series, 14-13. Thrown underneath LePe to Bruce Peltzer. Still on his feet, but he's out of bounds. Almost to midfield. Pickup of 20, 3:28 left. Ryan has to get into the end zone in a hurry. There's Kevin Campbell thinking about it. Picks up the first down. Across midfield down to the 43-yard line. Ten remaining. LePe now looking pass into the middle. Tim Dumas, did he catch it? No. Hard hit by Ed Boron as Dumas tried to catch it. Incomplete. Second and 10. Draw play. Cavallero. Room. Tight to the sideline. Finally knocked out of bounds by 22, John Malik. This could become interesting yet. LePe to the right side, intended for Dumas. The flag is down. Let's see. I think that could be against Ryan. Tim Dumas, number one. Jim Noon, number 18. Both using their hands to fend off each other. The call goes against LaSalle. So it is defensive pass interference. That'll take us from the 27, half the distance, 13 or 14, depending on the placement. And it'll be first down. First and 10 at the 13, 2:49 left. Chris Kennedy, he's almost into the end zone. No, the ground caused that fumble. The whistle blew. Chris Kennedy charging hard up the middle. Down to the, let's see. They're going to have to take a look because it's in the neighborhood of the three, and that would be a first down. It is a first down. First and goal now at the three, 2:41 left. Ryan about to go in, perhaps. Full house backfield. Cavalero takes it outside, untouched, into the end zone. Touchdown, Ryan, Chris Cavalero on the 3-yard run. Brings the Raiders back. There you see him, Chris Cavalero, accepting congratulations. Number 22, the 3-yard scoring run. Now, the extra point. Tom McKenna will kick it out of the hold of Dumas.
And that's the extra point, Tom McKenna.
It's good. That halves the score. 14 LaSalle, 7 Ryan, 2:22 left. And LaSalle looking for 11 people with good hands in anticipation of the onside kick. Ryan McKenna now with 3 people to his right. And all the rest to his left. All the guys with good hands for the Raiders. LaSalle with backs up in the front 5. There it is, bounces, comes up high. It's tipped. Lou Decree jumps and gets it, but I believe that was tipped before it had gone 10 yards. It definitely was. Lou Decree makes the recovery for Ryan, but that ball was hit by one of the Raiders before it had gone 10 yards. So LaSalle gets off the hook there. Good call by the officials. Run it back on your VCR at home if you don't believe us. Joe Malizia on the job with the camera work. We hope. We just had a signal there from the referee, Nick Ramo. We believe he pointed in the wrong direction. He pointed as if Ryan had possession of the ball, but it will be LaSalle ball, definitely. As you can see, the ball is placed at the Ryan 48. That's where one of the Ryan players tipped it up in the air. Lou Decree jumped up, made the recovery, but the kicking team is not allowed to touch the ball until it is gone 10 yards. First and 10, Explorers, 2:21 left, the clock is running. Gordon will take his time here. 2:21 it began, the sequence. Now what do we have? The 2-minute warning. Minutes, LaSalle trying to ride it out. That's Lakowicz. Bowls over one tackler, brought down by the other, Rakowski. Timeout. 153 by Ryan. Second and 7. Give to Lekowitz. He's a little bit towards the outside. Picks up about 5. Timeout again. 144 remaining. Huge play here. Ryan has one timeout left. It will be used if LaSalle does not get the first down. And they don't even have to because they threw the ball and that stopped the clock automatically. Brett Gordon incomplete, underthrew Lekowitz. That brings us to fourth down. Huge play because it gives Ryan a chance to stop the clock without having to use that last timeout. Again, we'll look for Ryan to bring the entire student body. Drew Middlemiss, back to punt. No problems, good protection. Rakowski catches the line drive punt at the 11, looking to get out of bounds. He does not do it though. Yes, he does. Now the signal that he got out of bounds. The clock will start. 1:24 left. From the 20, Lepe throws the sideline, the out. Dumas, not looking to get out of bounds though. You got to catch that and run to the sideline. 1:12 left. Ryan uses its last timeout. Second and 5. 1:12 remaining. Ryan, 75 yards from the end zone. Lepe on the bootleg. Along the sideline, Todd Carmody breaks it up. Intended for Dumas. Third and 5. Single setback is Kennedy. Here comes Lekowitz. Lepe. No one to go to. Overthrew Peltzer. The pressure from Lekowitz has an effect. Fourth down. One minute remaining. Fourth down. 5 yards to go. Ryan. Here comes Lekowitz again. Underneath the screen pass to Kennedy. First down yardage as he leaps. Chris Kennedy gets the first down, but Ryan's going to have to scramble. Once the ball is set, the clock will run up to the 33-yard line. And second down, Lepe just down the ball intentionally to stop the clock. Oh, he goes down. First on him is number 47. Brendan Coyle. The clock running down to 35 seconds. Again, intentionally downing the ball. It's a tough way to live. Thirty-two seconds left. Lepe has to throw it short. No way they could even get a first down. It's incomplete, and that's going to do it. LaSalle, unless they commit a monumental mistake, is going to be the 1995 Catholic League champion. The Explorers lead at 14-7, 27 seconds remaining. You see Joe Calistra receiving congratulations. Now we go out to the action. Brett Gordon is just going to, we have movement there on the left side of the LaSalle line. Number 75, Dave DeLillo, gets a little happy on the farm, excited about the impending championship. Joe Callister has already been doused. There you see Joe, soaking wet. 5-yard penalty. Still 27 seconds. LaSalle High. First championship since 1989. Gordon goes back, and that's going to do it. They won't have to run another play. There you see the celebration. And here come their fans. Holy Christmas, look at this avalanche. Up and over the fence, out onto the field. 2-1-0. The LaSalle High Explorers of Coach Joe Callistra win the 1995 Catholic League Championship 14-7. The theme from Rocky being played by the band. 11 consecutive wins for the Explorers to close the season. They started off with losses to West Catholic and Cherokee of New Jersey. Reeled off 11 in a row. Two touchdowns on runs. Kyle Malik, Mike Durso. The kicks by Brett Gordon gives LaSalle the 14 points. Ryan made it interesting at the end, fourth quarter. 3-yard touchdown run by Chris Caballero with 2:22 remaining. And then the onside kick, it did not go 10 yards. LaSalle maintained possession. And we're going to say goodnight from Northeast High's Charlie Martin Memorial Stadium. Thanks for being with us. Again, the final. LaSalle, your 1995 Catholic League champion, 14. Archbishop Ryan, 7. Good night. 41.
wheel in motion. Yeah, I'm gonna have to penalize you. Backfield in motion, baby. You know that's against the rules. Offside and holding, yeah. You ought to be ashamed of yourself, baby. Offside and holding, yeah. Holding on to someone else. Ready for this?
after time. I've done my sentence, but committed no crime. And bad mistakes, I've made a few.
For the Catholic League Football Championship. The fine young men who play football for Archbishop Ryan High School have been in the Catholic League Championship game so frequently in recent years that they can almost pencil it into the school calendar before the season begins. But this season, they know they are in for an extremely stiff challenge from the outstanding players of LaSalle High. Yeah, and the LaSalle Explorers were definitely ready to play at Northeast High School tonight. They go up by grinding it out 7-0, and then watch here, Mike Durso, he's been injured. They didn't know if he'd play. He gets in for LaSalle. They go up 14-0. But Archbishop Ryan has that proud tradition that I mentioned. So the Ryan Raiders are going to battle back. They're right back in it at 14-7, but the Explorers hang out. LaSalle Prep wins the Catholic League title 14-7.
Joey Galloway and Brian Blade. Tonight, LaSalle versus Ryan. Mike Durso scores for the Explorers.
Come out a little bit.
Take the picture. Hey, I'm going down.
Yeah, that's the winning touchdown in the Catholic League title game. They're excited as they win 14-7 LaSalle over Ryan. Also tonight, Middletown, Pennsylvania, Plymouth White Marsh ready for the
playoff time in high school football. We head to the Northeast in the Catholic League Championship between LaSalle and Blue versus Ryan. LaSalle's Brett Gordon hits Mike Matea with a big pass play, sets up the LaSalle touchdown. Kyle Malak goes in for the short score. LaSalle beats Ryan 14-7 to win the Catholic League Championship.
Stay with us, folks, and you'll see the best two teams in the Catholic League battling it out for the title. That's next on the Inquirer High School Sports Show. This week's Shopping Bag Big Game Spotlight shines on the Catholic League as LaSalle and Archbishop Ryan battled Friday night for the championship. Mike Skloot has the story. Tonight's championship is a rematch of a game played back in late September when LaSalle beat Ryan 29-19. It was their first win over Ryan since 1988. For LaSalle to duplicate that feat, they must have yet another primetime game from quarterback Brett Gordon, who's already thrown for over 2,000 yards this season. It's Ryan versus LaSalle in the Catholic League final. LaSalle was more than ready. But Gordon did have his troubles at first with the slippery surface and the Ryan pass rush. So he turned the ball over to the running game and number 42, Kyle Malik. But the one time LaSalle got close to the end zone, Ryan denied them entrance. Here, number 59, Dave Alt gets the pick, and it's scoreless at the half. Third quarter, different story, and a different Gordon. As he picks up big yardage on the ground here with the 12-yard run, and through the air to his favorite receiver, Mike Mattia, with a nice grab and stretches all the way down to the one. Next play, it's Malik, who bulls his way in for the sixth. LaSalle up by a touch, and the fans wanted their championship. It looked like LaSalle would get it. Next possession, Gordon again, this time to Jack Hammond. Same drive, fourth quarter. It's number 23, Mike Durso, who just won't go down until he hits Pater. LaSalle now up 14-0. That means 14 push-ups. Well, I guess four is good enough when you're up two scores. Ryan responds with Chris Cavallaro, who rumbles deep into LaSalle territory. He would eventually get in the zone. From 5 yards out, it's now 14-7. Ryan has one last chance, but on fourth down late in the game, the pass is incomplete, and LaSalle does it, winning its first Catholic League final since 1989, 14-7 over Ryan.
We had confidence that we could do anything. You know, this is the highest goal we can go, you know, in our league, and, you know, we accomplished it.
We knew we were going to be able to do this all season long. We knew that. We could stick together, and we were a team, and we just did it.
After losing their first two games of the season, LaSalle rolls off 11 wins in a row. Capped off here tonight with a 14-7 win over Archbishop Ryan to capture the Catholic League crown. It's LaSalle High, the 1995 Catholic League champs. Reporting from the Shopping Bag Big Game, I'm Mike Skloot.
I see trees of green, red roses too. I see them bloom for me and you. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I see skies of blue, clouds of white, the bright blessed day, the dark sacred night, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world. The colors of the rainbow, so pretty in the sky, also on the faces of people going by. I see friends shaking hands, saying, how do you do? They're really saying, I love you. I hear babies cry. I watch them grow. They're like much more. To myself, what a wonderful world. Yes, I think to myself, what a wonderful world.
Inside your heart. the sorrow that you know will melt away. And then a hero comes along with the strength to carry on, and you cast your fears aside, and you know you can't survive. So when you feel you'll finally see.